Hello. I am. Can I repeat that prayer? Hallelujah. So I just pray, first of all, also that the word that the Lord's given me, that it'll come across and that you'll get it today. I had a dream this last week. And in the dream, I was walking along this corridor, and all along the sides were just this mountain of textiles and what seemed to be blankets and stuff, but it was a mountain of stuff. And as I was going further, it seemed to be getting more and more intense and caving in on me. And it was like, it became so claustrophobic and overwhelming that everything inside of me was like, this is going to fall. I'm going to suffocate in here. And there was a lady behind me, and I pushed her back and said, we've got to go. This is going to topple on top of us. And then I was taken above, and I could see the place where I was. And there what I could see was these small pocket incidences of what I'd just been through. But it was small pocket incidences, and they were scattered along the way. And between them were these wide open corridors or paths that meandered between these incidences. And it was almost like a maze, but with wide open paths. And so as I was looking at this from above, I was told this is the beehive effect in my dream. And so I woke up. I knew it was a significant dream. I knew it was the Lord speaking to me. I didn't have internet at the time, so I couldn't look up Beehive Effect, but I was anxious to look up what is the Beehive Effect and find out from God what is he saying. Now, there were several elements within the dream that the Lord was speaking to me personally about, you know, that had a personal impact on my life. But what I see is more in this dream that there was patterns upon patterns upon patterns, wheels within wheels of stuff, one thing bearing on another thing, and that this thing has influence on that thing, and this thing has influence on that thing. And it was just like there seemed to be just this bearing upon one thing after another, almost like the kingdom of heaven. Almost like what I felt like the Lord was saying, it's like living the kingdom of heaven here on earth, and how to live the kingdom of heaven here in this world that we are, where there are constant variables interacting the whole time, all the time. There are variables that are happening around our life all the time, that one thing happens and it creates another effect over here. And that there are always just these varying outcomes. So you interact with this thing and it has an effect over here. And as you interact with that thing, it has an effect over here. And there's just these variables, constant variables all the time in our life. There's almost nothing that you can put your hand on and say, this is absolute. Because one thing bears upon another, and one person's actions have an effect on another person's actions. And when Papa said to us in the beginning of the year, he says, keep it simple, I believe that the Lord is giving strategy in terms of how to cope in a world that is so full of variables. And he's saying, keep it simple, because we are going to be experiencing complexities. And we do experience complexities in our life all the time that we are faced with. And sometimes we are stuck in those complex places. We are stuck in them. We feel overwhelmed by them. We feel like they're going to cave in on us. We feel fearful and sometimes completely unable to move, because of these circumstances that we face. And sometimes we are also faced with the temptation of becoming like the world while we're in this world. Amen. And just to blend. James 2 verse 5. Listen, my dear brothers. Has not God chosen those who are poor in the eyes of the world to be rich in faith and to inherit the kingdom he promised those who love him? Amen. I'm going to read it again. Listen, my dear brothers. Has not God chosen those who are poor in the eyes of the world to be rich in faith and to inherit the kingdom he promised those who love him? Amen. There's the kingdom for us to inherit as we are rich in faith. Keep it simple. Allows us to always go back to the source. Keep it simple helps us not to be overcome or overwhelmed by the circumstance that I'm in, and allowing all the emotions and the attributes of that situation to completely swallow me up. But keeping it simple allows me to quickly go back to the source. For the kingdom is what? The kingdom is righteousness. It's peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's say it. The kingdom is righteousness. It's peace and joy in the Holy Spirit. Yes. That's Romans 14 verse 17. In 1 Corinthians 4 verse 20. For the kingdom of God is not a matter of talk, but of power. Amen. The kingdom of God is not a matter of talk, but of power. Amen. Or in 2 Timothy 1 verse 7, of love, power, and a sound mind. Amen. These are the attributes of heaven. The kingdom of heaven. Yes? Hello, did you get that?
Yes.
So as I face one of these variables that has collided with my perfect plan in life, okay, how do I absorb the shock of it, lose control of the plan, and still keep moving forward even though the path might need to be altered? Hello? Okay. I come back to my source. I come back to my love. I come back to my peace. I come back to my joy. I come back to my source of power. And I come back to that place of being of a sound mind. Amen. I come back to the origin of it. I take back. I take back my joy. I take back my peace. I take back my love. I take back the power, and I take back me being of a sound mind. Amen.
Amen.
And I say, enough, enough. I stop right here and I claim back what is rightfully the environment, the situation, the circumstances that I should be living in. Amen. When we hear of 25-year-olds and 20-year-olds and that whose lives in the Lord have got such purpose, have been robbed and stolen away, I should say, this is enough now. Amen. We need to start rising up in the power that we have and not constantly be robbed, robbed, robbed all the time and say, God, let's get more passionate. Let's get more passionate. Let's seriously start calling on the name of the Lord. Amen. Former heavyweight boxing champion, Mike Tyson. Hello, who knows Mike Tyson? Said, everybody has a plan until they get punched in the mouth. Okay. This is what is called a complexity in, this is what is called complexity in action. Okay? Some call it the beehive effect. Isn't that interesting? Some call it the beehive effect. A beehive is a living organism that has from 1 week to the next, from one moment to the next might seem as though there's clockwork, but from 1 week to the next, it's always changing in a beehive. There's constant change. Interesting. business strategist, this guy Peter Senge, he says, human endeavors are systems. They are bound by invisible fabrics of integrated actions on each other and can take years to fully play out their effects on each other. Cause and effect are subtle and where the effects over time of interventions are not obvious. Okay. Again, just in simple terms, one thing has an effect on another thing, and over time you can eventually see that effect, but it's not always obvious. Amen. We are the products of our environment. Amen. Due to choice. Due to choice. I choose how I am going to respond in the environment I'm in. Amen. And my choice then makes me a product of that environment. Amen. And how I was affected by it. For instance, rejection. Rejection, they'll say, will have two extremes because of choice. One will be suicide and one will be homicide. You choose. You cut that rejection off. Amen. You cut that rejection off. You cut that rejection off before it plays out its effects upon your life. Amen. You are accepted, you are loved, you are forgiven, you are redeemed by the love of Jesus Christ. Start getting into the love of Jesus and letting his love set you free from what is going to take a catastrophic effect upon your life and others. Amen. Your messed up life is going to have some effect on somebody else's life. Amen. Sorry, that was like harsh. But true. The world is not only a dynamic system, but it is an open dynamic system. Who's heard of open source programming? Right. You can see into how it all works. And it's the world is an open dynamic environment system, i.e. it's not only complex, but new things can be added to the picture to change the nature of the equation. Amen. So for example, off the shores of Peru, there is a complex ocean ecosystem. Okay. And it was functioning harmoniously. It was functioning perfectly. Until around, I think it's the 1950s, until in the 1950s, an enterprising fisherman group of people decided this is easy money because of these incredible anchovy masses that are in these shores. So here's easy money. And here is a harvest of something like 14 million tons of anchovies that they could use and sell for food for cattle and for pets. Now, the quene, I don't know if I said that right, quene is a seabird, quene eats anchovies. Okay. Now, the droppings of the quene, incredible fertilizer, feed the plankton. The plankton feed the anchovies, tuna, and sea bass. Okay. Quene, because of this, population dropped by 98.5%. Okay. Some ill-conceived person's actions destroyed the livelihood of generations of fishermen to come in that area and completely upset the ecosystem. Okay? Just because of their actions, the reaction or the consequence was terrible. Okay? It's the same as those who immigrated to Australia wanted to make it look a little bit more like England, so they brought in a lot of rabbits. And bringing in all the rabbits completely destroyed the habitat in a lot of the areas of Australia. Interesting, isn't it? It's all over the world. Even here in Cyprus. I'm not picking on the British.
Excuse me, I'm not picking on the British.
But there was a lot of water on the island. There were swamps everywhere. And so the British thought there was too many mosquitoes. Yep. So let's get rid of the swamps by bringing in the eucalyptus tree, which dried up all the swamps. And we have eucalyptus trees all over the show drying up all the water on the island. People did the same thing with all the trees. The island was full of trees and didn't think of tomorrow. Same thing is happening in the talks today. People's attitudes and people's selfish ambitions are ruining it for generations to come. Amen. Because of one or two people that are positioned in a place at the stake or the fate of a nation because they can't get it together. Amen. And so it happens all the time. And Isaiah 61 verse 3 of 1 to 3. The Spirit of the Sovereign Lord is on me, because the Lord has anointed me to preach good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim freedom for the captives and release from darkness for the prisoners, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to comfort all who mourn and provide for those who grieve in Zion, to bestow on them a crown of beauty instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, and a garment of praise instead of the spirit of despair. They will be called oaks of righteousness, a planting of the Lord, for the display of his splendor. Amen. We are a planting of the Lord for the display of his splendor. Matthew 4. This is Jesus in the desert and he's being tempted by the devil. I'm going to read from verse 3. The tempter came to him and said, "If you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread." Jesus answered, "It is written, a man does not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God." Then the devil took him to the holy city and had him stand on the highest point of the temple. "If you are the Son of God," he said, "throw yourself down, for it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and they will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against a stone." Jesus answered him, It is also written, "Do not put the Lord your God to the test." Again, the devil took him to a very high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their splendor. "All this I will give you," he said, "if you will bow down and worship me." Jesus said to him, "Away from me, Satan, for it is written, worship the Lord your God and serve him only." All the kingdoms of the world were shown to him, but Jesus had another plan. Amen. Jesus had another plan. Revelations 11:15. Then the seventh angel sounded, and there were loud voices in heaven saying, "The kingdoms of this world have become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever." Amen. Amen. That plan is his people. Amen. That plan is his sons and daughters, those who are called by his name. We can't control unpredictable circumstances. We can't control the world, or we can't control people's lives. Okay? Hello, I need you to get this. You can't control unpredictable circumstances. You can't control the world, and you can't control people's lives around you. Okay? Full stop. You can't control. Okay? Never. Never. Don't even try. But to create conditions for the intended future to emerge. What we can do is we can create certain conditions for the right things to emerge in the future. And it's what God does in our life, isn't it? He creates circumstances. He allows us to go through things because through our choices, he's going to channel us into the right place that he has for our future. Amen. But the same thing is true for us. Okay, so if you're taking notes, number one, an empowering context for the future. Okay, an empowering context for the future. Basically, what I'm saying is we need to create a framework in which we can operate. And it's us to how we are to perceive, how we are to act, how we are to think, and how we are to relate to one another. So we create a framework of how we are to live and move and have our being within this framework. How we to think, act, and relate to one another. Okay? We still always have a choice. Each person has a choice. You can't override that choice. They have a choice. Okay? But we can create this framework, and still there will be so many variables, but I can still always go back to my framework. Okay? And my framework, that which will empower the context that we are in, is love, honor, joy, support, generosity, and we can keep adding to that framework of how we relate and respond to one another. Amen. We create this framework for our future. We create this framework of how we're going to start changing the environment around us. Amen. And we're going to say our framework is love. Our framework is to honor. Our framework is to have joy. Our framework is to support and be generous and so on. Amen. Is it making sense to you? The second thing is coordination and alignment. So A, share this commitment. Let's share this commitment. If we are going to be a group of people, let's be committed to this. B, ways in working together to fulfill this future. How can we work together to make these things happen? How can we work together to fulfill the future that the Lord has for us? And then C, knowing our place and calling within that framework, within the body of Christ. Amen. Now this is my place. Here I can operate. Here I can live. Here I can be who God's called me to be. Amen. Constantly for us to be adapting to the punches in the mouth. Amen. We don't go and have a hissy fit about the punch. We adapt and we see how are we going to maneuver around this thing. I come back to my framework. Amen. Third one is integrity and accountability. And it's helping each other grow through vulnerability and encouragement, encouraging each other, how we can spur one another on, how we can keep encouraging each other. Come on, let's just keep going. Like, let's say, for instance, when the men meet on a Monday and they said, like, let's see, what is the Lord saying to you? And you need to be having your daily bread because this is your source of life. You need to be asking God, what is my daily bread? Let's encourage each other. Let's stir one another on. Are you having your daily bread? Because really it is the sustenance of your life. You can't live without it. Amen. Encouraging, being vulnerable, allowing the light of Jesus Christ to shine and not hiding. Say, Jesus, let your light shine. Expose what you need to expose, not for the sake of shame, but for the sake of healing, for the sake of restoration, for the sake of building and not tearing down. Amen. And Jesus does that. Jesus exposes stuff. Jesus brings things to the light. He brings things to the surface because he loves you. Amen. So that it can be dealt with. So that you can be free. So that you can be a blessing to the body or the framework in which God has placed you. Amen. One of those things in integrity and accountability is lose control. Lose control and allow growth, new ideas and creativity. Take risks within that place. And to allow things like that, the creativity and things like that, to come from unsuspected sources. You see, if we're so busy controlling others and ourselves, what we are doing is we are limiting the abilities and the creativity that could come from people that we thought may not. Amen. Let go of the control and let God do something in people's lives that can surprise us. Amen. This is empowering people and ourselves to co-evolve and develop with each challenge. Amen. For us to develop, for us to grow in the challenges that face us. We can't stop them. We can't stop the variables that happen. And they are good. These things that are happening are good because it's how am I going to respond at this very moment to this thing? I go back to my source. If I'm fearful at this very moment, I feel overwhelmed at this very moment, I feel like this thing is suffocating me, it's taking over my life, I need to go back to my source and say, I've lost my joy. I've lost my life. I feel powerless at this very moment. Amen. Is take it back. We are the planting of the Lord for the display of his splendor. Amen. To transform the kingdoms of this world to become the kingdoms of the Lord. Amen. To transform the kingdoms of this world. And we think, nations. Yes, we are going to see nations transformed. We're going to see nations and kingdoms brought under the lordship of Jesus Christ forever and ever. But those kingdoms are all areas where the devil has stolen places, of where he's taken authority, where that authority needs to come back. Amen. Because Jesus knew when Adam forfeited the kingdoms of this world, where he was supposed to be the one who was given stewardship over the kingdoms of this world, he lost it. He forfeited it. He gave it over to the devil. The devil had authority over it all. Jesus knew it's coming back. Amen. It's coming back. And where the devil has taken over authority in your life, where the devil has taken over and made himself almost head of the kingdom, of that kingdom in your life, transform it. Take it back and bring it under the lordship of Jesus Christ and let him be Lord there forever and ever. Amen. That's it. That makes sense to you today?
Yes.
Good. It's called the Beehive Effect. Well, yeah, you can say that today. You can say this morning that I'm going to make that a framework of my life. I'm going to make that a framework of how I operate at work. I'm going to make that a framework of how I operate when I drive my car. I'm going to make that a framework of when I interact with the world around me. I'm going to interact with the world around me and with those people that God's put in my life with love, with honor, with joy, with generosity, patience, support, peace. And when my friend needs power, I'm there to stand with them. Amen. So let's make that a framework for our life. And here, amen. Number two, we commit ourselves to it. So Jesus, we thank you this morning. We thank you, Jesus, for dreams. We thank you, Lord, that you say things in dreams that would sometimes just, we just not see it. And I thank you that you take us when we're in that vulnerable place of just sleeping and you speak into our lives. I pray for more dreams. I pray for more strategies. I pray for areas where we can take risk and experience creative explosions in our life by simple things that you put on our hearts, even in a dream. So we pray, Jesus, let there be more dreams. Because you so speak to us out of those. It's when our lives are less cluttered. And I pray, Lord, that we would start to see the world around us transformed by the choices that we make to operate simply in the framework of coming back to the source of our love, of our joy, our peace, our righteousness, our power, and being of a sound mind. And that we can just live simply in a very complex world. And that we take the punches gracefully. In Jesus' name. Amen.